Hello, hello, hello. My name's Nigel Fletcher, and this is me brother Neville Fletcher, and this is Hello Governor. Our web-based telly show about all things Cockney East End, like tea and bowler-style hats.
Oh, good God.
So, just keeping kind of catching up here. We've got a ton of records to show. We had a record show last week. We apologize for the confusion in the last video that implied that there was a 3-day record show. We meant we were 3 days away from a record show.
Yeah.
But nonetheless, it was a great record show. We both have good days. I'm still showing stuff from before the record show. We're going to try to remember where we got these all from. Sometimes it's a little bit difficult, but I'm pretty sure on all these. I'm actually still showing stuff from the last record show. So
I'm not even there yet.
Oh, boy. Yeah, we are. We're backed up.
Yeah.
One of our new favorite guys. I don't know what to call him other than guy in the corner.
Yeah.
He doesn't really have a... We haven't developed a personality-based nickname for him yet.
Yeah.
But Good Ben's in the corner. That guy is here. It's been great. And from him, I got first pressing of Electric Prunes. Kind of speaks for itself. I think if you're into psych, you already know about this album. But obviously, Too Much to Dream last night, kind of one of the first song I ever heard by the Prunes. This is a great album all around. And this is the mono copy on the tricolor label. As I said, it is a first pressing. They go for a lot of money. This guy had $7 on it, and I talked him down to $6. And he was great about it. Really, this guy does actually make me a pretty good deal every time. Anyway, it's a great record. I'm really, really happy to have it, and I got a fantastic deal on it, and it sounds pretty good. Again, if you can find the mono pressing, it really does. Even if it's not looking in good shape, it's worth picking up. Most of that surface noise is going to get drowned out on the mono. It's cool.
Rolling the sleeves it's up. Just, it's getting
warm.
Serious in here. It's
warm.
Getting real.
All right. Well, I am going to remove my chapeau as well. So, hello, Governor.
All right. All my finds. I'm sticking with more eBay stuff.
You're hitting it hard on the net.
If you're watching these and I tell you the price and you've like been sitting there with a calculator, you're like, oh my gosh, the dude's made of money. No. Some of these are back from like as far back as like May. All right, first up from the eBay pile, this is the Fox for Fox's Sake Volume 1.
Oh, yes.
You see what they did there?
I do.
You see?
They took the word.
Because the F word, and they made it the Fox, though. And so, yeah. It's tough to find this. It has sort of a perforated tear-away poster on the front. If you can see on the back there, you could tear this front cover off, hang it up. So it's kind of tough to find it with that still attached. Usually you just see it like this. So yeah, I was pretty happy to get this on eBay. $13 shipped. Kind of the price point I was getting a lot of these for, which is a pretty decent deal. It doesn't go for a ton more than that, but with the poster, it's a little more desirable. This is really good. Kind of pop psych, almost in a concept album vein, but overall pretty good, pretty enjoyable album. I don't think it's great. I think it's mind-blowing or anything like that, but it's solid. And if you've got a lot of psych and you're like, I just want some more, I don't know what else is out there, this is a pretty good one to pick up. You won't be disappointed with it, at least. Sneeze. It's coming on. It went away.
Okay.
Oh, I hate it. Hate sneezing. Hate
it. I think it's one of the most relieving feelings in the world.
Oh, no.
Unless you get the gooch sneeze.
The gooch sneeze is bad.
Oh.
I told you, I get like the inner elbow pain sneezing sometimes. Like, I don't know if my body just seizes up when I sneeze.
Yeah.
But
you've never had an ice cream headache.
Never had an ice cream headache. For a long time, my brother and I thought they were a myth.
You thought that was a joke.
Yeah.
Oh, like, that's the weirdest. All right. Okay. Side note. This one is an upgrade copy for me. It is not in the greatest shape, but it is a first pressing with the die-cut sort of novelty cover of The Doors, LA Woman, an album I am just over the moon for. I think this is great. Obviously, The Doors' debut self-titled LP is a classic, but I have to say that if I'm choosing a Doors album to listen to, this is the one I tend to gravitate towards. LA Woman, obviously, and Lover Madly are singles, but The Wasp, Texas Radio and the Big Beat, I think is the real gem of a track on here. I think this album it was a return in many cases to the Doors. In fact, I think in our very first video, I talk about scoring my older copy of this, or the copy I previously had. This is an original pressing, so an upgrade. He made me a good deal on this as well, so I feel good about what I paid for it. It was under market value. Out here we are stone,
immaculate. This next one is one I think you would like a lot, sir. This is SRC Milestones. This is their second album. Their first one, I believe, is just self-titled. Really cool psychedelic cover on the first album. This one, I don't know, almost looks proggy.
Yeah.
But it's not. This is these guys were from Detroit. This is like early Detroit hard rock with a little, you know, some psychedelic tinges, some flourishes. That's the word I was looking for. I really think you would like this a lot. The opening track, No Secret Destination, is the standout track. Really good stuff. Want to check out Psych Professor. Get on that.
Next one, not straight psych at all. There's a guy who always has kind of a hodgepodge bin and then a smaller bin of psych stuff priced as marked, but his hodgepodge bin is just $3 and I'll make you a deal if you buy a bunch of them. I saw this, I'd never seen this record before. Swordfish Trombones, Tom Waits. Kind of getting into Tom Waits for $3.
Yeah, it's a good.
It is in great shape too. Minor ring wear up at the top there. Looked like it had been played once or twice. Really enjoy a lot on this. The title track's good. Frank's Wild Years, which is kind of the track that gets talked about the most, does live up to the hype. It's everything you want in a Tom Waits song. I don't know what else to say. If you like that type of stuff, you'll like the whole album. If you're like, oh, that's weird and kind of mean to dogs, you'll be like, yeah, maybe I don't want to buy that album. But I like it a lot. Swordfish Trombones, Tom Waits, $3. It's a first pressing. Couldn't pass it up.
Gallon of gas and a can. Drove home, doused everything in the house, torched it.
This next one's from a group. I don't know if I got their second album this year or last year, but I was really big on it. Wanted to find their first one, and it did not disappoint either. This is Time, aka Trusted Men Everywhere. I still think that's a stupid, pretentious, blame name for a band. It's self-titled, cool kind of like die-cut cover there with the plastic film over the front. You open it up, see that it's like see-through.
That's neat, but I don't get it. Why do they
I don't
do
either.
It?
It just seems unnecessary, doesn't it? Yeah. It seems a little pretentious like their band name. Yeah. The second album is Smoothball. It's a little bit harder, bluesy psych rock.
Yeah, I've been looking for that one for a while.
Yeah, I think it's
that
one
cheap,
you would
though.
Like.
I wanted at the price.
Yeah.
I'm not willing to pony
to
up for that.
10 to 15 is
yeah,
is
I'm
a,
not going to pony
like
up past 10, I don't yeah. think, on that one.
This one's in about the same price range. I think you can find this one a little bit cheaper, and it's a little bit more pop psych. Really, really solid pop psych. I think these guys were kind of an underrated and overlooked band. So it's one, like, they're not crazy expensive because they're still a little bit under the radar.
Might have been the bad name.
I think it has a lot to do with it. Hear the sound of
love comes blazing. All right, these next three I got at GB's. I've talked about it a bunch. Great store here in Decatur. And I was shocked to see this in there. Now, before I show this record, I want to sort of preface by saying I don't think this lives up to the hype. Let me also addendum to the preface, I might be willing to trade on this one.
Ooh.
So maybe you won't be that upset with me when I show you Shuggied, Otis, Inspiration Information. It's good, it just doesn't hit it for me. I out of my head, kind of the track that everybody thinks is the standout one on this one, but Shuggied, Otis played everything, did most of the production himself, went way over budget, and Epic Records just, it took them like 3 years to make this album. That doesn't sound like anything to us now, but in 1971, when he started making the album, that was just unheard of. So anyway, came out in 1974, Shuggied, Otis, Inspiration Information, $8.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Well done, sir.
Yeah, that was a steal. What do you think about this for an album name? Oral Inhalation. Up next, it's the Lame Name Band from their album Oral Inhalation. This is something stupid.
All right, this next one's a little bit deeper psych, straight psych, Mr. Flood's Party,
yeah.
Self-titled. This one usually goes for like 30 and 40. I found a copy on eBay. There was a copy for $10, no bids, with like an hour left. I threw on a bid. thought it's gonna lose. I didn't even check my eBay account again until the next day, and it was like, you have an item in your cart, you won this for $10. So it was like 14 shipped. Really, really happy with it. Deep, kind of dark psychedelic rock.
Nice.
It's a really cool one to check out. Oh gosh, the Liquid Invasion standout track.
Nice.
And a cool name. That'd be
very
a good
cool.
That'd be a good song. Maybe Oral Inhalation could cover Liquid Invasion.
It's the lame name band. Oral Inhalation
is
the album title.
Sorry.
Also on that trip, picked up a first pressing on Dunwich Records of Shadows of Night, Gloria.
It's awesome.
Great record.
It's fantastic.
Number 666 in the Dunwich catalog. Oh, pumped to have the Shadows of Night, Gloria.
Yeah, fantastic, man.
I don't know what else to say about it other than that it's more than the single. It's all pretty good. Hoochie Coochie Man in particular. A lot of Willie Dixon covers on this one. Chuck Berry, some John Lee Hooker. It's kind of what you would expect for Garage Fair, but it is above the grade. Really good. And if you can get it on that Dunwich label, that's cool too. And knows who I am.
Killer boots, man!
All right, last but not least, this one actually I think I got on Discogs. Not positive, but this is the Music Machine Turn On with Talk Talk. This has been kind of a minor grail. It's not one of those that's out of my price range necessarily, but I didn't want to spend the top dollar for it. So I got this with shipping. It was $24. So Pony Up for me, that's definitely a Pony Up album. But other than a little bit of a seam split at the top, it's a really clean copy. Seminal garage album. This is kind of like the Shadows of Night. If you're into garage psych, this is a must-have. Talk Talk, Masculine Intuition. The track that Inside won, really dug it. We're gonna play it on the show soon.
Sweet.
So yeah, really cool find. Happy with this, big time.
Good stuff. I've got a masculine intuition. And then one more record to show here. This one I'm not too high on either. I think it's kind of the weak spot in an otherwise great epic of an artist's career. So Stevie Wonder's fulfilling this first finale. It doesn't have what I'm looking for on it. It's not bad. There's nothing about it as you're listening to it that's, I don't know, unpleasant or displeasurable, but Stevie Wonder in the 70s, it's not like you can go wrong, but this one just doesn't feel right.
Confession, not that big of a Stevie Wonder guy. I like the hits, the stuff that gets radio play.
Yeah, me too.
That's about it.
I think Stevie Wonder is a kind of a, he's a two-disc greatest hits guy.
Yeah.
For me.
Yep, same here. Yeah, there you go. Confession. For sure.
Part two of my confession. And all four of these records, boom, 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 and boom, are 1001 You Have to Hear Before You Die. Well, that's another record run video. We're kind of getting through these pretty quickly here. We hope you've enjoyed it. Love the comments. Love the feedback. If somebody you know also watches us and they're like, oh, those guys haven't posted in a while, let them know that we're kind of cranking them out week by week here, at least for the next 2 or 3 weeks.
Yeah.
So that's happening. Thanks so much for listening. Really appreciate it.
Yeah.
Check out the show, Psychedelic Experience. Links in the information and everything like that.
And as of this filming, we're at 499 subscribers. Once we hit 500 and above, we're planning on doing a contest. We don't know what the details of that are yet, but kind of keep an eye out for an upcoming video once we cross that threshold.
So, yeah, it'll be great. We'll see you next time. Until then, avoid scratches, stay in the groove.